All right, next one is keep ease of preparation a priority. If I could only pick one tip on here to talk about for an hour, it would be making sure that preparation is a priority, the ease of preparation, okay? You might see something on Facebook, like one of those, you know, BuzzFeed videos or whatever it's called, or you might see something on Pinterest and it's like, oh man, that looks amazing and it's healthy. Where has this been all my life? And then you look at how long it takes to prep, it's like 2 hours because it's this and that. You gotta go pick, you know, quail eggs, then you gotta go find a kumquat from Peru. I mean, like, that's great and everything, and that's cool, but the ease of preparation is pretty damn high. So what's the likelihood if you're not only gonna prep that this week, but next week and the week after that? So the ease of preparation should be a priority. And this is even where you can get into things like frozen meals or frozen vegetables or frozen fruits, or try to marry kind of this convenience yet healthy thing that we're starting to see in grocery stores, right? There's some decently healthy meals, not a lot of them, but there's some decently healthy meals that are whole foods based in your local grocery store freezer section, all right? Or in the refrigeration section. It's not like you have to prepare everything from scratch and go to Italy and pick olives from there and then bring them home and then, you know, prepare it. I'm not saying that, but you want to try to find some kind of ease of preparation, because if you don't, this is the first thing that dies. And you can probably attest to that just, you know, watching this video. You're probably shaking your head like, yep, the harder it is to do, the less I'm going to do it. That's just human nature. At some point you do have to get over that to be an adult, but to a certain degree, especially when you're beginning a new skill, like trying to simplify nutrition yet make it, you know, the most healthy that you can consistently, ease of preparation needs to be a priority. All right. All right. And the very last tip I'm going to be talking about is strive for consistency, not perfection. Okay. What do I mean by that? I'll give you a very classic example from a client that I was working with about a month and a half ago. This person nailed their prep on Saturday, actually. So they went shopping on Saturday. They prepped what they needed, which didn't take them a lot of time, on Sunday, and they killed it on Monday. So they did really well on Monday. They did really well on Tuesday. And then Wednesday, a coworker said, hey, we're all going out to lunch with, you know, one of our coworkers. Do you want to come with us? And, you know, per my coaching, I told him, I said, look, go out to have lunch. It's totally cool. You know, you've not only kind of earned it, but you've proven that you can meal prep and stick with it. Having lunch with your coworkers one day a week is not going to kill your results. So this person went out, had, you know, lunch, and then the next day they didn't bring their meal prep, right? They didn't bring it. And so that coworker said, hey, I noticed you didn't bring your lunch. Do you want to come out with lunches with us today? And what I told this person after the fact, because the rest of the week kind of fell off. So Monday and Tuesday were good. After that Wednesday, they fell off. And it was because they were focusing on being perfect, right? They felt guilty about going out to lunch. Excuse me, sorry. They felt guilty about going out to lunch. And so they said, screw it. I've ruined my consistency. I went out to lunch. I didn't have my meal prep. I might as well just give up, right? That is a very bad, and if I might be frank without being judgment, immature attitude to have when you're trying to have to attain a goal, all right? It would have been perfectly fine to Thursday wake up and have your meal prep as if Wednesday never happened. And that's how you have to think about those things. Because listen, it's not about being perfect. Is not how you get to being healthy, to living longer, to not dying of chronic disease. The secret to all of that is being consistent and being able to quote unquote get knocked down and get back up as if you never even got knocked down. That is one of the most important phrases that you could ever learn about anything. If you could put that on your wall and that be a mantra for yourself for the rest of your life, that would be awesome, because it is about consistency. There is no perfection in the world, all right? So when it comes to your nutrition, if you can do really good on Monday, do really good on Tuesday, fall off the wagon for some reason on Wednesday, get back and do it again on Thursday, so have success on Thursday, that means that Friday is more likely to be successful, which means going into the weekend you're more likely to be successful, which means that the next week, because you overcame something you thought you couldn't do, you're even more successful, and it just keeps going on and on and on. The more you can learn that when you get knocked down, you get back up, and you don't think anything more about it than that, the easier time you're gonna have, and the more consistent you're going to be, all right? So that's my video for you today, guys. If you have any comments, questions, or concerns, or you want me to elaborate on any of these points, or you just wanna say hi, make sure you put it in the comment section down below, and I will see you in a future video.